regular councilman, February 26, 2020, to rise and pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Mayor Nenez?
Here.
Mr. Magistrelli?
Here.
Mr. Scherr?
Here.
Ms. Nosowski?
Here.
Mr. Hibbs? Ms. Miller?
Here.
Mr. Boykus?
Here.
Mr. Bryan?
Here.
Mr. Wazowski? Chief Zogus?
Here.
Mr. Walters?
Here.
And I am present.
Approval of the minutes of February 12th.
Still moved. Second.
Motion by Ms. Noack, seconded by Ms. Nosowski, to approve the minutes of the February 12th, 2020, regular council meeting. Is there any discussion, questions, or amendments? Hearing none, all in favor of approval?
Yes.
Yes.
All opposed?
Abstain.
Mr. Scherr's abstaining, he was not at the meeting. So the minutes are approved.
Anyone in the audience have anything for us tonight? Hearing none, moving on. Reports to municipal officers, the mayor doesn't have anything to report at this time, we have the finance director of spot bid.
We are currently finalizing the proposed 2020 budget and preparing for meetings with the department heads. If anyone has any questions or concerns, please let me know. And completing our final filing of the year for our financial statements to the state. And that is in preparation for our audit, which will be probably late summer this year.
And Ms. Putvin, I think, you know, we asked when you might be ready for the budget meetings, and I think you said you need another next week to get ready. So that would be starting the week of March 9th. The council meeting is on the 11th. So Mr. Magistrelli, I don't know if you want to just kind of tentatively schedule those department meetings, figure out what day we're shooting for, whether it's before the,
you know what,
on the 11th or.
I would like to get different with the head of committees and get the department heads, find out when they will be ready, and then I'll call the spot bid and we'll go for that.
That's great.
We'll just kind of coordinate.
Yeah, I just didn't want it to fall through the cracks that was show up at the 11th.
Oh, no.
Because I think it's, we want to do them before the 11th if we can.
Okay.
Because the plan is to have a first reading on the budget for on the 11th and have it.
Well, you know, I think our biggest budget is going to be service. Jen?
Don't pick on us.
Well, it's always the toughest one to get through, again. Yeah.
I am fairly open. My only constraint is the 9th. So we are looking at that week. That's the only day that I'm not available.
Can we tentatively schedule something for next Wednesday then?
Oh, before. She said she needs another. Oh, wait, we'll
be
going in.
Yeah, that's too soon.
No, yeah, you gotta go one more.
Is that too soon, Mrs. Potter?
We can pull that together for streets. I don't have a lot of changes for streets. So we can do that. All right, let's see.
Ninth?
No, ninth week will be the fourth.
So, okay, I'm in the wrong week, guys, hold on. Here we go.
What time?
Can we do? Oh, dear. Anyone available on the 6th? That's a Friday.
Yeah.
Jay?
I'm not.
I didn't think so.
I don't care, I do it.
I'm not available on the 6th.
I didn't think so. Okay, so I'll just tell you what I got and you guys can pick. I can do Tuesday the 3rd after 7:30. Thursday the 5th after 7:30. Unless anyone wants to do it earlier, but then I know daytime work is difficult.
The 5th would be next Thursday.
That's Thursday, yeah, I can't do that.
Okay, how about Tuesday? Is anyone available Tuesday the 3rd? Jason?
Well, thank you.
That works for me.
that's okay with, whatever day is fine with me.
Before the council meeting works for me.
I don't know about Chief Bus. I don't know if he's gonna be scheduled to work in Richmond. So I'm
Sure Joe would be first.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty spelled out, I think, so.
How long do we need? An hour, half hour?
To be safe, an hour.
An hour, so for the fire and safety on the 11th, 6:30?
Is everybody okay with that?
Right, does it, right?
Let's clarify, Tuesday, March 3rd, 6:30 PM for service.
Correct.
Police Wednesday, the 11th, 6:30, and fire hopefully also.
Does that conclude your report, Mrs. Puffin?
Yes.
Moving on, Mr. Rosowski, the engineer, is not here. He'll be at our next meeting. Mr. Bryan, law director.
Thank you, Mayor. The only thing I have, the bid opening for the fire station renovation and addition and renovation project. Bid opening was 4 o'clock on Monday, and I passed out the sheet of the bids, and the low bid was deal below the estimated figures, so that is always good news. So, got some decent bids that were below what was projected. So, and the architects are doing their due diligence on the low bidder and next candidates, and will have a recommendation for us prior to the next council meeting as to what they.
Just to clarify, Brad. We're not doing anything with that until the budget is approved, correct?
Well, we have 30 days to, from the bid opening to award the contract. So we need to act by then. So we would not have to do it by the meeting on the 11th, but we might have to have a special meeting, let's see, because that would be the 25th. I think that actually might be, I mean, doing the math in my head, 29 days. Oh no. I think we're still over by a day, so we would have to have a special. But the thought is to, was to give the architects time to do the due diligence and have some budget discussions, at least have a tentative budget so everyone understands how it's put together. So might then just have the legislation on the agenda at the 11th. Decide at that point whether to move forward or whether we need additional time and schedule a special meeting to just deal with that issue.
And that would work because we're having the budget meeting right before that, so if we see that we need to go to a second reading or something like that,
that's correct.
We can go ahead and do it that way?
Sure.
Can you explain what the comments mean, please?
Oh, the comments are just the personal property affidavit wasn't included, filled out with the lowest bidder, but that is not something that's disqualifying. Under Ohio law, we cannot award a bid to a company that owes, that's delinquent on personal property taxes with the state of Ohio. Personal property taxes were eliminated, I think, 8 years ago. Some people still have lingering personal property issues from. But the way the architects actually did that form, it said upon award of the bid, they have to present at the time they're told the lowest bidder, they need to fill it out and submit it. So we talked with them. They've claimed there's no issues. We can verify it. The architects can verify that with the state of Ohio, and the form would be submitted prior to that. So it's not. It's not disqualifying the way the most part.
of February 29th, Officer James Catania will be retiring. He handed in his retirement letter. He's been with the village for 18 years. Jim was a part-timer, you know, he worked all the weekends, loved to work the weekends. A lot of business owners loved him and residents. Jim actually worked about over 1,000 hours a year. So Jim will be missed. So at some point we'll have a retirement badge for him, so on and so forth. So I just wanted to mention that. That's it.
Jason Buss, the fire chief, will be our next meeting. Jason Walters, the resident building superintendent.
I don't have much to report other than just trying to get our budget finished up. But a big part of this would be what we want to do with the playground. So I don't know if you want to, I have to imagine we're going to have some kind of dialogue with that tonight. So if you want to do it now or later. Well, are we looking for my opinion on the playground equipment that's in Parma?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay. Well,
we might as well.
Well, so if I'm not mistaken, it's something that we could purchase for about $5,000 or $5,000. I have looked at the equipment, and I'm sure everybody's seen the pictures of the equipment. I think that the value of the equipment is definitely worth $5,000, you know, as far as what it would cost to purchase that equipment. In my opinion, just trying to, you know, I don't know, and I think Gary's trying to find or reach out to the company that installed it, and perhaps sold it. I don't know who that is. I haven't been able to talk to them. Gary said that when he got in touch, you know, he would let us know or let me know. But I feel that trying to guesstimate, because I don't have an actual, you know, there's no way to really figure this out. I would feel that, you know, like a low number to get it torn down and brought over, and that is something we can maybe even look at trying to do. But I still think we'd be at least $40,000 into it with the purchase. It is quite a bit cheaper than the new playground equipment that we had bid on, or got a quote on, I should say. But they're not apples for apples. I mean, we're talking, you know, a much different playground setup versus this one. So we could either, one, try to get something that would be comparable to get an idea what it would cost new. There is some wear and tear on that equipment. If I had it my way, and I don't know where we are budget-wise, I think that in the best interest of the village, we'd be best off buying new. That would be my opinion. I don't think that if everybody felt strongly to go that way, I don't think that you'd get hurt. But there is some concerns, and then, like I said, you could get into, there's a lot of variables until we can really get it quoted as to what it would cost us to set up and things like this. You know, Chris and I have looked at, you know, trying to say, hey, what if we tore it down and load it up, we have a bigger trailer, things like this. And there's just a lot of things that come along with this, and I think the best way to do it would be hire a company to tear down, set up, put the responsibility on the company. And I have to think that you're going to be, you know, $5,000 for the equipment. To me, that's a no-brainer. That's the easy part. But I still feel that at minimum, maybe we, if no one likes the equipment that we have a bid on, is trying to be comparable to what's sitting there as far as the big tower and kind of having that wow factor that's sitting there with a lot of the kids that love that big tower and things like this. This doesn't really have that big tower, and that is a costly, you know, there's a lot of cost to that. So if you want to rework something, you know, we could look at that, you know, to maybe look into this a little further, you know. A lot of things concerning when you buy used and what you might end up getting into. So that's my opinion. I don't know if I left you too much gray area. I would rather see us get new, but in the end, it's really going to be about budgeting for it. So that's where you guys come in.
I'd like to pick up where Jason just left off. I have been talking to Miracle Recreation Equipment Company, who was the original seller or vendor, and they also installed the equipment there at that school. I am in the process of getting a cost for two different companies that Miracle does use in Ohio to remove it and install it. So, I mean, as Jason said, just looking at equipment, I feel the equipment's a great price for them. I mean, we may even look at putting that at the second place. It is going to be probably a big cost to move it. I don't have those numbers yet, but as soon as I get them, I will forward them to everybody.
Thank you, Gary.
Just to add in there, the chief and I did go there this weekend, and I think, just like from speaking to you, I think it's an excellent cost for, you know, for us. But I think it's all going to come down to, once again, the budget. And then, as I've been very vocal, we really need to look at handicapped equipment also. So if we can look at apples to apples, like you're saying, like this is what it is and this is what it is, then we could go ahead and do more of a comparison, especially after we have the budget in place.
May I add to what Mrs. Nowak was saying?
Yes.
I did have the opportunity to take a vacation recently, and I was also looking at some playground equipment there. They have some excellent special needs playground equipment. So I kind of sent her some emails showing her how the equipment works, and she really likes that. So there is a lot of stuff out there for special needs kids too. So we would want to add something to that.
Thanks for your time on that, Gary.
No problem, Mayor.
Well, I think we're moving along at the right pace. We don't want to jump into this. Both via time, I think we need to look at all of our options. I sort of agree with Jason about new equipment.
We're also getting down the wire with the budget.
Well, that's what I mean.
Yeah. Well,
we're still not going to have
it. Here's the big factor. We all know that the equipment sitting there, we've gotten our life out of it. It's time. So it's either being that it is about to be March, you're talking, you know, let's. Spring's coming, but I mean, kids get out of school, what, first week of June? So that's, you want to try to have it up relatively close to that, or at least started, you know, so that playground might not, that play area might not even be able to be used this year. So at minimum, we also kind of probably think, you know, it's time to, let's just plan on taking that old equipment out. And maybe, you know, we might not be able to replace it until the end of summer. You know, I don't think anybody should rush on it. And Gary, you're not wrong. You know, there's some other parks that you can maybe start using some of that equipment at, and we can put a little bit more over here or whatever. But, you know, it's really about what it costs to take it down, and it starts to be, then is the value still there? If it was sitting in our yard right now at 5,000, then just hurry up and write the check.
And again, we don't want to rush, but just so that council knows, they're getting ready to raise that building, so I don't know what they are planning on doing with that equipment at that time. So.
Does that compare for your report?
It does complete my report, Mayor.
Reports of Municipal Reports and Commission. Planning Commission, Mr. Hibbs is not here. Does anyone on that have anything for us tonight?
I'd just like to remind everyone, Mayor, that we are planning to have a March meeting on the 18th, and it's to approve the plat for the Sorrento development on the old Snow properties. Shouldn't be any issues with that. It's just the.
Are those Dollar General. Okay, Recreation Board. Recreation Board will meet next week on Wednesday, 6:30, here at the Town Hall to discuss Easter, adult Easter egg hunt, and children.
That's March 4th.
Correct, at 6:30. Cemetery Board, we have not had a meeting yet. As soon as we do, I will give you the agenda and open the boxes. And until that time, I have nothing to report on the Cemetery Board. Of course, the standing committees, Mr. Magistrelli of Finance.
Yes, we had our monthly finance meeting this evening. I want to thank Mrs. Bonding for having it all put together and make our jobs easier. I also want to thank my committee for being here and getting it done. A lot of conversation about playground equipment and stuff that we're going for the budgets now. It's kind of an exciting part of the year, and I just want to thank everybody and have a good day. Thank you.
Mrs. Tomzowski, Roads and Public Works.
No report this evening, Mayor.
Mr. Sheriff, Health and Welfare.
No report.
Mr. Voitish, of Wages and Working Conditions.
No report, Mayor.
Ms. Nowak, of Fire and Safety.
Yes, Mayor. We did have a work session this evening to go over a proposal from Northfield Center for their asking us to assist them in replacing the Sheriff Department. And that concludes my report.
Thank you. Mr. Hitz is not present today. Does anyone have anything for Buildings and Grounds?
Thank you, not Mayor.
Okay, thank you. Moving on. Legislation, Mr. Bryant.
Thank you, Mayor. First, we have ordinance number 2020-08. Emergency ordinance amending section 258.04A of the codified ordinances relating to holidays for full-time employees. It's on first reading, and if everyone will remember, this is the amended version of, I think, 2020.05 that changes requested by council were made, and I don't know how anyone feels about the new version, but let me know what council's.
What is council's pleasure?
May I ask you a question, please?
Absolutely.
I know we're dealing with full-time employees. Do we need to add either a 32 or a 40-hour number to that? Because at one point, 32 was considered full-time, with 29 was considered full-time. I'm not sure which. Do we need to add that number to this or no?
I would say no, Mr. Wojtyś. The standard for providing health care based on federal law is different than considering somebody a full-time employee for Fair Labor Standards Act purposes. So at this point, the three full-time employees that this would apply to work 40 hours a week, if that would change, then I think we could amend it at that time.
And then I do have one more question. Do we need to relate anything on that paperwork that specifies a non-union employee?
No. I mean, union employees are covered by a contract, and that
right.
prevails over any codified ordinance. So,
The thank you.
Provision of the union contract is different than that applies. This just applies to the
I'm satisfied with the way it's written.
I'd like to suspend the three reading rule.
Second.
Motion by Ms. Tomzowski to suspend the three reading rule, seconded by Mr. Magistrelli or Wojtyś. Mr. Magistrelli, all in favor of the motion?
Yes.
All opposed?
Motion for passage.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Wojtyś, seconded by Mr. Magistrelli to pass. Discussion. Hearing none, all in favor of approval?
Yes.
All opposed? Ordinance is adopted. And we also have resolution number 2020-09, an emergency resolution authorizing the mayor to enter into an agreement with HMH Restoration LTD for the Village Hall East Wall and Stairs Area Project on first reading. This is the same company that handled the South Wall rebuild area and the wall going down to the police department is deteriorating.
Do we have a cost for the quote for this?
Yes, we do. It's $35,295.
I'd like to make a motion to skip the three readings.
Second.
It is a huge emergency for safety wise.
Motion by Mr. Wojcicki, seconded by Mr. Magistrelli to suspend the three reading rule. All in favor of the motion?
Yes.
All opposed?
Motion for passage.
Motion to pass by Mr. Wojcicki, seconded by Ms. Nowak. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of passage?
Yes.
All opposed? Okay, the resolution is adopted. That's it for the legislation, Mayor.
At this time, is there any old business, new business, or announcements? I have some old business. I'd just like to say that, you know, I am really strongly against going with Northfield Center in any capacity for police protection. I feel that there's not enough information at this point, and I don't think they're going to provide me enough information to change my mind. Thank you.
I in turn would like to comment on that. I am not comfortable at all sending one officer down to that size of an area. I feel that something may happen. I also feel that it may happen here, and I, my personal opinion, I don't want to do it.
You're not going to risk any officers.
And, I mean, they're also offering us $150,000 less than their current paying.
Yes.
I think that our chief is really would be a better judge than any of us here.
Well, I've always said, you know, either way, I'm okay. It's what, you know, the mayor and what council wants to do with that. Could we do it? Could we handle it? Yeah, it's without a doubt. Would there be some profit in it? I'm sure there would be. But it's what, you know, the governing body of the village would like to do.
At this time, though, I just don't agree with anything that they have on that.
Like I said, I'm okay either way.
I just think that the numbers that we have were a lot of numbers, and if we were ever to even consider it, then those are the minimum numbers.
They said, like they said, that they make a counter offer with that. So I mean, that's what
there's a lot more convincing you're gonna have to do here.
I don't have to convince.
No. I mean them. Right. I mean the township. So, I mean, just not for at this time.
So would I want to reach out to them to see what they want to counter with, and have them come out again, or just go ahead and have all of us make a decision as to how we want like to go?
I think we just need to make a decision.
Right. They want us to either counter or. So I think you're right. We just need to decide whether we're just not interested at all, not gonna bother.
Well, I agree with Gary. One officer is not enough. I'm not going to send one officer out there by himself. There's no way I'm doing that to someone. Absolutely not.
So,
those are too important.
So if I could go back to them with a counter saying that we want at least two, and bring to their attention what their budget currently is with the sheriff's department, and it needs to be amended, as well as I made the notation to them that we don't know what the numbers are going to be after the first year, that we want to have that listed as well, that we want to relook at it in a year. Do we want to do that, or do we still want to make that decision that it's a no?
For me, I need a lot more information before I can even have a valued opinion. You know, I mean, what I'm looking at is I'm looking at a couple numbers. I don't know. I mean, I know what we're comparing, what they're paying now to what they're offering us is less. I know our cost is going to go up. I know how many calls we went on last month. I don't know how many they went on. I think there's just, for me, there's a lot of missing information before I could even really.
I think the big red flag was is that the sheriff's department still has not yet provided any documentation.
Well, wait a minute. Did I hear from a trustee that was sitting out in this room telling us, well, we get monthly reports? Well, then you should know what you did in January. I mean, I don't understand that.
They contradicted each other.
Did he not say
he
that?
Did he did say that. Right. He did.
And one other thing to note too, as far as, you know, I think they extended the sheriff's contract, if I'm not wrong, through this year,
yes,
like for an extra year to kind of.
No, they have to sign their new contract by September of the previous year. So their actual 3-year contract ends December 31st.
Okay. For some reason, I thought it expired last year. They just extended for a year.
That wasn't the case. From what I remember being at the meeting, is that that's why they were trying to expedite it, is because it was to end at the end of last year, and it was going to go month to month. And then they probably renewed it because nobody came aboard
without looking
at
it.
And that's what I'm about getting to. Macedonia looked at it, you know, for starting this year, and was not interested in doing it for less than what the price of the sheriff's department is.
Also consider this. I mean, we are considering it, but at what these numbers that they're showing us in this proposal, there is so much missing here. I don't even know how you could say yes to this.
You know, something else to realize too is they are now dispatching through the sheriff's office, so their dispatching would go to our dispatching center, and that would incur and also a cost for that also. So that would go up for us also.
I would be curious to see, in the event that we were to actually consider, I would like to see what our counter would be, and if it's even close to what they're considering is optional for them, price-wise.
And another thing I think of is also our insurance would go up, so we'd be paying additional insurance.
Well, here's another
if
thing.
If we get sued for something that happens there,
here's another thing.
Deductible cost.
Sagamore Hills, Northfield Center, Macedonia. They jumped into an agreement with fire, and look at the problems they're having. I'm not about to jump in an agreement here that's going to put us in the same light. I'm not doing it. Period.
Decide whether you want to actually submit a bid or not.
We can see for us on our end what it really is going to cost us, or you know, that we would need them to pay, and then we can come together and we can review the numbers amongst ourselves and really decide, is this something that we would even offer to them?
So then do we want to do another work session for the simple reason is they have a deadline, April 24th, that we need to let them know by, so that if we do decide that we want to let them have a counter, that gives them the opportunity to come back.
I would like to see.
I've been in jail so many times and they've done this and they've done the same thing to us. They railroaded us every time.
Did they solicit Sagamore?
Yes.
Yeah.
Could I ask a question? I'm getting a little confused. We're talking about us countering them or them countering us?
We would have to so that we have their offer in front of us. That's what they're offering us. So we would have to come up with a scenario that we would be willing to do for them. So we would need to give them basically the same type of document with the different breakdowns and the pricing. But for me, I would like to see that anyways, even if we decide we weren't giving it to them. I think I can't vote on that or you know, really talk about it unless I know.
A comparison.
All right. I think that's something Chief Zogas could probably come up with, and maybe I could put another set of eyes on it. Right by is Potvin, and you know, always keep in mind there's always going to be unknown, something we didn't think of, and something that's going to be.
I think it's very noble what council's trying to do. I do. I can't do this.
And then, like the mayor said, you know, you have to look at it. Is this in the best interest?
Do have some new business. It's just a thank you. I would like to thank you to Elrod and Tiffany in our service department, because in working on the Easter egg hunt, with the mayor being out of town last week, I reached out to them to give their opinion on what I was putting in for the tickets, and they took full hilt and are working on the tickets, working on the flyers, and we're gonna finalize everything at our next meeting. But I just wanted to reach out and tell those two girls how much I truly appreciate all that they do. Thank you.
And Renelle, and to add to that, I'd like to thank you for all that you've been doing on the banner project.
Speaking of the banner project, I was speaking to Elrod today, and she says that the door just did not stop opening today for people still wanting banners, even though the deadline is close. So we, reaching out to everybody out there, we only have like a handful available for the polls. So if you want them, get it into me, because I'm hoping to finish it up next week so that we can get them printed. So I'm very excited about it. Thank you.
And Gary, I'd like to thank you for coming down to service today and helping out. Getting things going with the Easter egg hunt. That was very nice of you to do that.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm always happy to help.
Okay. There's no executive session yet at this time. Do I hear adjournment?
I'd like to make a motion for adjournment.
Motion by Ms. Nemzowski to adjourn, seconded by Ms. Nowak. All in favor?
Yes.